He's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
They face a third and four after that last completion gets them six. And again, it's Mahomes. And it's complete. It's Damian Williams. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. Mahomes going to go on fourth down. He is going to find Hill here. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. They're able to keep the drive alive 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. To throw, it's Mahomes. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Trey Flowers picks it. And a good return here as he takes it up past the 30-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Wilson, the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at about the 32. First down, Seattle on a pickup of 13.
And while we're seeing more and more of these plays come from the college game into the NFL, and that one, it was run with great success. How about the evolution of the offensive linemen? We're seeing less and less big guys who can't move and more guys who are a lot more mobile and can get out in front of that type of a play.
Wilson gonna fake the give and keep it himself. They go quickly here out to Moore. Well, as a lineman, they are trained. You've got to stay close to home. If you're more than a yard downfield, they're going to toss that flag, and they did there. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Being chased out left. Now he'll pull it down. Give him a couple on the scramble, it's second down.
Now how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Throwing again on second down. Wilson, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Emmanuel Ogba. He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. We're scoreless after one. Throwing on third and long. Wilson, he'll rifle this one deep. And that's caught inside the 35. And that goes as a gain of 37 on third down. For an offense that has not found the end zone yet, that's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Wilson going to fake the give and keep it himself. He'll find Metcalf. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. DK Metcalf, 30 yards, as his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This will be taken short. Trucks over him. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Chiefs' offense about set to begin this drive.
And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down. Speaking of Damian Williams, great Super Bowl. 17 carries, over 100 yards, and a touchdown on the ground. Charles, he also had one through the air. Did you think he would have that type of a game?
I wasn't sure that we would see that type of a game, but I knew he would be a part of their offense in terms of trying to break down what San Francisco does, that he would get the bulk of carries. But did I see 104 yards on the ground and a touchdown? Probably not. Did I see him catching one as well, 133 yards total offense? Probably not. But give him his due, because now in his postseason career, which is six games, five of them with Kansas City, one with Miami, he scored 11 touchdowns.
Wow.
So on the big stage, the big lights, he produces, and he actually won the battle between undrafted free agent running backs, because his total versus Raheem Mostert, who ran for, I believe, 58 yards and a touchdown for San Francisco, advantage Kansas City, advantage Damian Williams.
From the gun on third down, Mahomes. They complete it to Hill. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. And they just keep marching right along. First down on a pickup of eight there. They go back to the ground with Williams. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about four.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense, because you're excited about hitting him in the first half, maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
To throw on second and six, Mahomes complete, the tight end Kelsey. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Mahomes looks to throw on third down, and it's complete to Kelsey. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 17-yard line. It's Kelsey on the ground. And after the broken tackle, couldn't get free for much space. Taken down right at the 10. A gain of six there on first.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Mahomes hit. He lost the football, and the Seahawks have recovered.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk reward. And I don't know about but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit and in this case lose the football?
So should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20/20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
Following the fumble recovery, it's Wilson. Over the middle, that's caught by Metcalf. And he takes this just about a yard shy of the 20. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Now Wilson on first down. He hits his running back, Procise. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. Final play of the half, it's Wilson. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. A final shot before break. Wilson, and he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of his first half of play. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Seahawks with the advantage, and they get the football first as the second half is underway. This one taken from the 7. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. On first and 10, it's Wilson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Off the edge, the sack by Reggie Ragland. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones, maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Wilson's throw caught by Metcalf. Touchdown, Seattle. DK Metcalf, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. Always important to get the first score of the second half. Now you start to pull away a little bit and get some breathing room going.
And now we find out about the fortitude of the group that's behind, because they were counting on getting into the game a little bit more, right? Maybe they get the first score. That doesn't happen. It looks almost insurmountable, but it's not. Let's see how hard they play the rest of the game.
Myers connects on the PAT, and that'll make the score 14-0. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This will be taken very short. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger, but no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
Mahomes going to pull it out and keep it himself. Mahomes going to fire this out wide to Hill. 22 yards there, a first down. Well, they brought the pressure, and that meant man coverage behind him, so he's still able to complete the pass.
Even as he took the hit, and that's what you have to do, because I was just talking with a coach the other day, and he said, look, it's not always going to be pretty back there. You're going to have to give me completions. Even when you're taking some hits, sometimes you have to be your own blitz control, for lack of a better term. Got to make completions, step up and make those throws, and he did that.
They'll get it inside the red zone, but only for a couple down to the 19.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Throwing on second and eight. Mahomes. Robinson's got it. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. Mahomes going to pull it out and keep it himself. Gets this one to Hill. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. A 14-yard touchdown as his guys are back within a single score.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them play running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And nice work on the return as he'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They were able to extend their lead with an opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter, but that just got matched a moment ago.
So we know that what they discussed at the half worked. Now, what are the counters to that, right? You don't just run the same things over and over. Some do, but many will also show something and then come back with something else to keep the defense off balance.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. From the shotgun, Wilson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Emmanuel Ogba giving him once again his third sack of the afternoon.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
36 power.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play three quarters. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Wilson now, throwing on third and long, and he's going to go down again. The sack comes from Anthony Hitchens.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. What a run, 79 yards on the punt return, as they can now even this game here in the fourth quarter with the extra point.
And that jumps the excitement level up a few notches, doesn't it? What a big-time punt return for a touchdown. Now their cohorts on the special team side They've got to add the PAT.
That would be the equalizer. A very important extra point there, up and good. And an important one that is, as we are all tied now early in this fourth quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. This will be taken short. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. That one going to be complete to David Moore. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Making a hat trick for Russell Wilson. Three touchdown passes now. And the Seahawks have taken the lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This one taken just inside the 10. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Yeah, he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And they're going to be staring at a 3rd and long here. Working from the gun, Mahomes. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Sacked there by Jadeveon Clowney. Well, they went with a nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down. You bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
This offense converted once on 4th down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. 4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. And they've got a 4th down now in a game that, to be honest, has been pretty much everything we could have asked for. Mahomes throwing on 4th. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. Kelce, the intended receiver there.
And, Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
And now he'll tuck it and run. And all the way in, touchdown, Seattle. Russell Wilson. 38 yards. And the interception by the Seahawks D leads to a touchdown. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more caught? Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Ziggy Ansah in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. To try again after the sack. Mahomes to the right side, it's Kelsey. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down. Now Mahomes, and a quick throw here, that's complete. A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down. Mahomes now on first down. Now Mahomes can't get away, and down he goes. So now with 6 seconds remaining, we get a timeout on the field. So now 20 yards to go on 2nd down after the sack. Work to be done. One final try for Mahomes. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. So the victory here for Seattle, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one, we're thinking to themselves, I bet halftime was really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense it was much more of the adjustments they made. They came in with a game plan that we saw that didn't work in the first half. They made the adjustments necessary, went away from that, and then they got it together, got a spark, and then took off. It's really nice to watch in the second half.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. From Kansas City, so long, everybody.